Good morning, friends. Article 3, Section 1. The judicial power of the United States shall be vested in one Supreme Court, and in such inferior courts as the Congress may from time to time ordain and establish. The judges, both of the Supreme and inferior courts, shall hold their offices during good behavior, and shall, at stated times, receive for their services a compensation, which shall not be diminished during the continuance in office. Section 2. The judicial power shall extend to all cases in law and equity arising under this Constitution, the laws of the United States, and treaties made for which or which shall be made under their authority, to all cases affecting ambassadors, other public ministers and consuls, and to all cases of admiralty and maritime jurisdiction, to controversies to which the United States shall be a party, to controversies between two or more states, between a state and citizens of another state, between citizens of different states, between citizens of the same state claiming lands under grants of different states, and between a state or the citizens thereof and foreign states' citizens or subjects. In all cases affecting ambassadors, other public ministers and consuls, and those in which a state shall be a party, the Supreme Court shall have original jurisdiction. In all the other cases before mentioned, the Supreme Court shall have appellate jurisdiction both as to law and fact, with such exceptions and under such regulations as the Congress shall make. The trial of all crimes, except in cases of impeachment, shall be by jury, and such trial shall be held in the state where the said crime shall have been committed. And when not committed within any state, the trial shall be at such place or places as the Congress may by law have directed. Section 3. Treason against the United States shall consist only in levying war against them, or in adhering to their enemies, giving them aid and comfort. No person shall be convicted of treason unless on the testimony of two witnesses to the same overt act, or on confession in open court. The Congress shall have power to declare the punishment of treason, but no attainder of treason shall work corruption of blood or forfeiture except during the life of the person attainted. Article 4, Section 1. Full faith and credit shall be given in each state to the public acts, records, and judicial proceedings of every other state, and the Congress may by general laws prescribe the manner in which such acts, records, and proceedings shall be proved, and the effect thereof. Section 2. The citizens of each state shall be entitled to all privileges and immunities of citizens in the several states. A person charged in any state with treason, felony, or other crime, who shall flee from justice and be found in another state, shall, on demand of the executive authority of the state from which he fled, be delivered up to be removed to the state having jurisdiction of the crime. No person held to service or labor in one state, under the laws thereof, escaping to another, shall, in the consequence of any law or regulation therein, be discharged from such service or labor, but shall be delivered up on the claim of the party to whom such service or labor may be due. Section 3. New states may be admitted by the Congress into this Union, but no new state shall be formed or erected within the jurisdiction of any other state, or any state be formed by the junction of two or more states, or parts of states, without the consent of the legislatures of the states concerned, as well as the Congress. The Congress shall have power to dispose of and make all needful rules and regulations respecting the territory or other property belonging to the United States. And nothing in this Constitution shall be so construed as to prejudice any claims of the United States or of any particular state. Section 4. The United States shall guarantee to every state in this Union, a republican form of government, and shall protect each other against invasion, and on application of the legislature or of the executive, when the legislature cannot be convened against domestic violence. Article 5. The Congress, whenever two-thirds of both houses shall deem it necessary, shall propose amendments to this Constitution, or, on the application of the legislature of two-thirds of the several states, shall call a convention for proposing amendments, which, in either case, shall be valid to all intents and purposes, as part of this Constitution, when ratified by the legislatures of three-fourths of the several states, or by conventions in three-fourths thereof. As the one or the other mode of ratification may be proposed by the Congress, provided that no amendment which may be made prior to the year 1808 shall in any manner affect the first and fourth clauses in the ninth section of this first article, and that no state without its consent shall be deprived of its equal suffrage in the Senate. Article 6. All debts contracted and engagements entered into before the adoption of this Constitution shall be as valid against the United States under this Constitution as under the Confederation. this Constitution and the laws of the United States which shall be made in pursuance thereof, and all treaties made or which shall be made under the authority of the United States shall be the supreme law of the land, and the judges in every state shall be bound thereby. Anything in the Constitution or laws of any state to the contrary notwithstanding, the senators and representatives before mentioned, and the members of the several state legislatures, and all executive and judicial officers, both of the United States and of the several states, shall be bound by oath or affirmation to support this Constitution, but no religious test shall ever be required as a qualification to any public or office or public trust under the United States. Article 7. The ratification of the conventions of 9 states shall be sufficient for the establishment of this Constitution between the states so ratifying the same, done in convention by the unanimous consent of the states present the 7th day of September in the year of our Lord 1787, and of the independence of the United States of America the 12th, in witness thereof. We have hereunto subscribed our names, G. Washington, President and Deputy from Virginia. Delaware, G. O. Reed, Gunning Bedford Jun, John Dickinson, Richard Bassett, Jake O'Broom, Maryland, James McHenry, Dan of St. Toss, Jennifer, Daniel Carroll, Virginia, John Blair, James Madison Jr., North Carolina, William Blount, Richard Dobbs Spate, Hugh Williamson, South Carolina, J. Rutledge, Charles Coatsworth Pinckney, Charles Pinckney, Pierce Butler, Georgia, William Few, Abraham Baldwin, New Hampshire, John Langdon, Nicholas Gilman, Massachusetts, Nathaniel Gorham, Rufus King, Connecticut, William Samuel Johnson, Roger Sherman, New York, Alexander Hamilton, New Jersey, William Livingston, David Brearley, William Patterson, Jonathan Dayton, Pennsylvania, B. Franklin, Thomas Mifflin, Robert Morris, George Clymer, Thomas Fitzsimmons, Jared Ingersoll, James Wilson, Geoff Morris, attest William Jackson, Secretary.